Well, the Forever Winter is out, and I want to talk about it. This is not a review or anything like that. I'll just show you what's in the game, the performance, the game mechanics, and talk about the state of the early access. I don't want to sound preachy or anything from the intro, but I want you, the viewer, to understand what's my position coming into this. And from that point on, if you're still watching, you can take useful bits and pieces out of what I'm talking about. First off, I want to talk about early access and managing expectation when a game like this blows up. The hype, while being good to an extent, can damage a game long term because of the huge influx of players expecting 10,000 different things from a pretty small studio in this case. I always adjust my expectations depending on the asking price, the monetization tactics, what's in the game, and last but not least, how I perceive the developers from the interviews and stuff like that. I'll talk about what's in the game in a bit. The asking price of 27 is more than fair, considering the price will most likely go up once 1.0 releases. I find this a very fair way of respecting the players who founded your project early in its development. Games like Grim Dawn and I believe Dirt 2 did that. And yeah, there are more examples. No extra layers of monetization are present at the moment in the game. And devs say there will be none going into the future, so no reason to believe otherwise, for now. Now about the developers, these guys know how to do a video game, clearly, as they are industry veterans from what I hear. They say all the right things we all want to hear, you know. Again, there is no reason to think anything else until this changes. They have integrity and say they don't want to nickel and dime you, so... And one more small note about managing expectations. While I like some of the content Big Fry and others creators do, mostly, I think these guys are more and more disconnected from reality, really. They seem to expect Call of Duty level of gunplay polish and character animations from an early access that's made by a team of 30 developers. My guys, do you know that Call of Duty is made by, I don't know, perhaps thousands of people? And yeah, I know for a fact. On a lot of mobile games, it's not uncommon to have a team of 100 people working on a mobile game, you know? So 30 is not much. And now, finally, with all this shit out of the way, let's go in. I almost forgot one more thing, and this one really bugs me. I can confidently speak about it before I even start playing the game. The water mechanic is bad and should be removed. Come on, guys. Yes, removed. Not adjusted, not fiddled with, no, removed, deleted, done, please get rid of it, thank you. For who doesn't know, you need to collect water from raids and that water keeps your base going for a number of days and weeks. And once it runs out, if you don't play the game for, I don't know, 55 days or something, your base just resets for some reason. And you lose all your gear and vendors. Listen, as much as I hate catch-up mechanics adopted by many games that help new players reach the veterans of the game faster, I hate the reverse mechanics like this when you're punished if you play less. Come on, guys. So, you know the mails you receive from different MMOs you played in the past trying to get your attention by sending you rewards if you come back and log in? You know that. Yeah, everyone does it. Yeah, the Forever Winter does the opposite. Anyway, that was my only big gripe at the moment with the game. Once in the game, I noticed the cool retro look of the menus, and I dig that. I really do. Straight into display options, I crank stuff to the maximum because I can. And let's see how well this runs, shall we? Then I disable the music because sadly I have no clue if I can use it or not on YouTube, so... Now the training mission sets a good tone, I got good vibes from that, game looks great, there's this clunkiness of the character movements and camera, and I guess that's intended. Very good lighting and nice details all around me. I hope the YouTube compression won't be as bad as I saw in other videos, because darker games like this tend to look like ass on YouTube. But so far, believe me, at least, it looks great. Now the game tells me to drop the water. Sure, boss, there you go. Okay, I just shot my pants just a tiny bit. No. Okay, so what I learned, hip shooting is not possible, or I couldn't do it, I couldn't aim for shit. I suck, and yeah, I suck more than I thought, basically. Let's go again. This time I can go straight to the extract. Thank God. Sweet home. Now, I enter the innards and explore it for a bit. Quests, squads, vendors, character, combat loadout. I get a lot of Tarkov vibes, of course. Which is not bad, but anyway, it's different. It's not like Arena Breakout, for example, who just copied Tarkov one for one, you know. This is different. You can see the similarities. I love the character design, but they all seem to have mostly the same strengths and weaknesses. I think it's work in progress, I hope. Because I'd like more variety in, I don't know. The last one, this one is the tank, okay, cool, cool stuff. I'm leaning towards Kev Girl because she's the fastest. But I kinda love the Shaman and, yeah, that guy from the trailers, so I picked that guy over the old man. Now I got a mission to explore an extract from Scorched Enclave. I go explore innards for a bit. I find a guy at the end of a platform that lets me upgrade my base. Pretty cool. But what am I doing? I got no money. So yeah, let's go. Let's go make some money. Make some money. I'm sure I will die a lot. Now, before my first raid, I got no idea what I'm doing. I just take the tactical camera, equip it, but somehow yeah, I moved my ammo and stuff into the weapons and ammo tab, I believe. After I sort my shit, we enter the first raid. Once loaded, it was pretty fast, by the way, but yeah, I got a good SSD. I stopped because a squad of cyborgs just spawned in front of me. And I slowly back off as I want to observe them for a bit to see what's going on, you know. As far as I can see, you're not pressed for time in this, so why rush? I'm not a big fry, no? Now the drones and the cyborgs start fighting. Man, I have no idea who's who. I don't even know if the drones and the cyborgs are the same faction. But they seem to be, because they seem to be shooting something else, but I can't see what they're shooting. But I notice the NPCs in the distance move in a weird way, you know. Yeah, that's too aggressive loading, guys. Try pushing the last load a bit further so it's not so evident, because it looks weird and cheap. So the AI animations, and not animations, the behavior really, it's a bit wonky. And by the way, about the AI, from what I read, in this game you have a threat level, and that's attached in some way to what you looted in that run, you know, what you have in the backpack. And I find that pretty cool. So because I got jack shit on me right now, I expect them to mostly leave me alone if I'm not aggressive towards them, or for no reason, or I go too close. No. Oh my god, I see tanks showing up. Then I hear big thumps. I suspect there are some of the big walkers robots nearby. Maybe I shouldn't linger so much because more and more forces spawn all around me. Yeah, I think I need to move now. So I got a bit closer, but I see a lot of enemies with my cheating equipment. Man, that's so cool. I love it. I like the fact that you can see enemies, and I suspect the yellow and orange things are loot locations, which is pretty nice. And look, the big robots to my left. Oh my god, and some tanks. And a lot of cyborgs in front of me. What am I doing? How do I pass everyone? How is this even working when you're in a squad, man? I'll try some squad gameplay tomorrow. Now I wanted to see how's the game alone. Oh shit, some drone is above my head. No, I've been discovered. Okay. Nice explosion. I love it. Now I tactically retreat. And the other drone just lost interest, it seems. Okay. Cool stuff. Let's push to the extraction zone then. Look at this. When you're into ADS, you can lean left and right with Q and E. In third person, Q uses your equipment slot. And that's pretty cool. So there's a lot of loot to my left. Oop, I'm not going there. I'm not big fry, no. No way, the game keeps spawning stuff around you. Oh my fucking god, I'm trapped again. I feel I'll get discovered if I stay here, so I retreat again to wait them out. No way I'm going to survive five of those guys, plus a mech or two. Now they seem to be engaging something, and I think this is my chance to slip to their backs. Yep, I think this is it. Run, Forest, run. So I get closer to my extraction point, but I know this is up to that pipe. So I need to go enter it from my left. But I see a lot of NPCs around the entrance. I guess I'll wait for them to leave or engage in battle or something. Man, this tactical equipment is so cool. I feel a bit safer with this thing. Even if I don't recognize that big pile of corpses at the entrance, I believe they are all cyborgs. Nice. Maybe I can grab some loot. Oh my god, that will be epic. First raid. Yeah boy, like a true rat. Oh my fuck, what's that thing? I think that's the big robot from the trailer that... What does it do? Transforms people into biomass or something. Oh no, more stuff spawning in front of me. Come on, game. Come on. Okay, I need to go back. No way in hell I make it inside the pipe. And even more stuff spawning. Jesus Christ, bro. What is this? I hope they have other elegant ideas for this, because it's immersion breaking and bad for gameplay, to be honest. I see myself out there in the open with some of these guys spawning around me. Yeah, I'm dead. There's no way around it. They literally spawned in front of me, and I'm sure if I would have been out of cover, I would be detected and killed, probably one tapped or something. Anyway, I managed to slip away. I got some loot off the bodies, then I go extract. What's with all the whiskey and stuff on the cyborg? I'm curious what's the lore behind that.
Always a pleasure, folks.
And I'm out. Nice. If I could do it, so could Big Ray. Anyway, I say this is a win in my book. No idea if I got something valuable, but I didn't die. In my book, that's mission complete. Now, I'll give you some sort of conclusion. My, I don't know, first impressions. My first impressions actually are pretty positive, especially because all the bad things I heard lately from the guys who played in the last weeks, more or less, is not too polished. I mean, you saw what I saw, right? The controls feel a bit heavy, but I think it's intended and they're actually pretty okay. The shooting is not bad, but there is almost no feedback when you hit something and get hit, other than pretty cool effects. I like the graphics and sounds. The performance could be better. I got the specs in the description, so I don't know if many of you can relate. So I can't really talk about performance, but from what I saw, if a 4090 can run a game at over 100 FPS, lower-end graphics cards will struggle a lot. Now, it depends on how well these graphical options work, you know, because maybe if you put everything on high, not ultra like me, it'll be a lot better. I don't know, but it's worth a try, you know. You don't need everything maxed out. The game looks pretty cool. It's very atmospheric, nice sounds, pretty cool. Cool stuff. And I think this game has a bright future ahead if devs stay true to their vision, for the most part. That's very important. The community is split, as far as I saw, and will ask all kinds of dumb things. So Fandog Studios will have to dig through piles of shit to get relevant feedback. I hope they don't end up trying to please everyone, because that's a very good way of failing, you know. Very few games could do it, and I doubt this can be one of them, because very niche. This is not Call of Duty, guys. You can't even try to begin to please everyone. Yeah, and I'm not saying the community is bad, because I think this of any community surrounding any game that got hyped very fast like this game was, you know. Anyway, my water mechanic feedback is the best, so listen to me 100% and just delete it from the game. You'll thank me later. Jokes aside, I hope you like this. Give me some love, a like and a sub for more videos about Forever Winter, gaming reviews, first impressions videos, all kinds of stuff. You are free to go now, Skev.